grip. Let's watch. Okay, you have firing thumb issues, because look, if I draw a line down the front of the trigger guard, look how much finger sticks out here. So you got to re-grip the gun. All that stems from the shoulders as well, right? But look, this firing thumb is pushing from the base knuckle, so the hand can't get to where it needs to be. And look, backstrap's back here. Where I want the hand is up and forward, but the thumb's there, can't get there, right? So where it is where the thumb allows it to be. A little bit lower, a little more forward. Got to keep that thumb high and neutral. And we also need to move that hand far back enough where if this is the trigger guard right here, right, this should be the line. Your hand shouldn't be past this line right here. See the corner of the trigger guard? Your hand shouldn't be past that line. Make sense? So we're going to move that hand straight back, probably about an inch or so. Okay, let's watch the trigger guard. Trigger guard still pulls away. See how it comes up, finger moves back. Trigger guard still pulls away, which tells me you don't have side-to-side pressure of the heels of the hand under the back strap of the gun. Problem is your hand's not on the back strap of the gun because of the firing thumb. So again, firing thumb high and neutral, non-firing hand needs to move back more. Okay, wrists. Both wrists break. Elbows break a little bit. Shoulders break a little bit, right? And it's not a lot of movement, but if you watch underneath, you'll see your firing arm moves more. Why is your firing arm move more? Because your shoulders aren't square to the target, and it's allowing the firing arm to take the brunt of all the recoil. Okay, how do we fix this? Shoulders up and forward under the earmuffs, just that little bit more. Firing thumb high and neutral, non-firing hand needs to move back, up and forward. I need you to push with the firing hand, pull with the non-firing hand, keep the gun from moving, right? Arms are already straight, keep that up. And then the last piece to all of it for you is push with the firing shoulder, pull with the non-firing shoulder. Keep your shoulders square to the target. When your shoulders are square to the target, we're going to be able to see the end of the trigger guard. Make sense?
Yes.
Any questions?